Discussion on percutaneous pulmonary valve implantation. Percutaneous pulmonary valve implantation has the elite distinction that it was the first percutaneous intervention for a regurgitant lesion in humans. Bonhoeffer and colleagues described the development of a system for percutaneous stent implantation combined with valve replacement for right ventricle to pulmonary artery prosthetic conduit with valve dysfunction. They used it in a 12-year-old boy with stenosis and regurgitation of a prosthetic conduit from right ventricle to pulmonary artery. Percutaneous implantation of bovine jugular valve in the conduit was successfully achieved in 2000. Echo, angio, and hemodynamic assessment showed no residual regurgitation and partial relief of conduit stenosis. There were no complications and patient was in good physical condition at 1 month follow-up. A report of 58 patients with a mean age of 16 years was published in 2005. Majority had variants of tetralogy of Fallot or transposition of great arteries with ventricular septal defect and pulmonary stenosis. They had undergone right ventricular outflow tract reconstruction in infancy with valve conduit and presented in later life for re-intervention for pulmonary regurgitation and stenosis. There was significant fall in right ventricular pressure, right ventricular outflow tract gradient, and pulmonary regurgitation. There was no mortality in the series. Data on 155 patients was published in 2008. Follow-up was up to 83.7 months. Freedom from re-operation was 70% at 70 months. Freedom from transcatheter re-intervention was 73% at 70 months. Survival at 83 months was 96.9%. First series of 50 patients and patients with a residual gradient more than 25 millimeters of mercury were associated with higher risk of re-operations. A review on percutaneous pulmonary valve implantation in 2015 opined that it is a safe and effective procedure. The procedure has the potential to improve symptoms, functional capacity, and biventricular hemodynamics. Limitation noted was that eligibility for the procedure was in less than 1/4 of the patients with right ventricular outflow tract dysfunction. The Melody valve crimped over balloon-in-balloon catheter was delivered through a 22F long sheath balloon catheter. 18mm device could be expanded up to 22mm. Coronary compression by the implanted valve is a rare but significant problem with percutaneous pulmonary valve implantation. Balloon coronary test has been used to check for the likelihood of coronary compression, but it is not foolproof and could have high false positive rate. When a short valve is needed, manual shortening of the Melody device has been used and is known as folded Melody valve technique. It has been shown to be a safe technique with favorable outcomes up to 6.5 years after implantation in a retrospective study of 49 patients.